I have sort of assumed after President Biden won that there, the feeling of unity and coming together would be something that would be happening. That Democrats would be wanting Republicans to come together with them to go forward. And instead, we're hearing a lot of language from people like Katie Couric, that Republicans like me need to be, quote, deprogrammed, that we're brainwashed, that 74 million Americans are basically irredeemable people that we don't need to communicate towards and we don't need to in any way have anything to do with. And I think it's horribly dangerous for the country. And I also think it's horribly dangerous for Democrats. If you don't care about unity, you should care about the politics of this. And if a President Biden and Democrats want to have a big tent party and include some of these people, great. And if we're all just deplorable and need to be deprogrammed, as Katie Couric said, then honestly, they can go to hell, because I don't need to be deprogrammed.
There are millions of Americans, almost all white, almost all Republicans, who somehow need to be deprogrammed. It's as if they are members of a cult.
It's because of Facebook. It's gotten out into wine moms and yoga groups, and something that started as innocuous online that turns into something completely different, Brian. And that's part of the challenge, as you write, of deprogramming, as you put it.
You know, Chris, the right doesn't like it when you say people need to be deprogrammed. You know that, right?
Deprogrammed?
Yeah, we're talking about the QAnon people and the conspiracy theorist people.
I feel like I'm missing something here, because I know what QAnon is and I know what their reach is online. I am not as worried about the duped as I am about the diabolical.
Voted for Trump, you voted for the person who the Klan supported. You voted for the person who Nazis support. You voted for the person who the alt-right supports. That's the crowd that you are in.
It was anything but massive fraud. And until Republicans can do that, until they can reject the big lie, they can't even open their mouths about unity. Shut up about unity.
That mob was not interested in unity. That mob was not interested in conservative principles. Unless conservative principles is inciting an insurrection and storming the Capitol and leaving feces behind in urine. Unless that's what it is, then okay, maybe.
Past 4 years, we've had a president who's made his contempt for our democracy, our Constitution, the rule of law clear in everything he has done. He unleashed an all-out assault on our institutions of our democracy from the outset. And yesterday was but the culmination of that unrelenting attack.
I unequivocally condemn the violence that we saw last week. Violence and vandalism have absolutely no place in our country and no place in our movement. Making America great again has always been about defending the rule of law.